Today, I am in Los Angeles, California, with my friend Mark. For the first time,
well, actually, technically the second time in person. The first time was many years ago when we did a meetup. This is the third time?
Coachella.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we've met up a few times. He's been on my podcast. You guys know of that, Aquariums Unfiltered. But we finally are going to see bits of his studio. And this is one of the tanks, or at least one of the first tanks that I really want to look at and take a look at. So, Mark, if you could, I want to walk through the overview. What do we have going on here, first and foremost?
So this is a Paludarium that I named Water's Edge. It's a 60-gallon, like a really low tank, right, on the bottom. But then I have like a plant wall that's about 5 foot tall, just about 5 foot wide right here upon it. And then the irrigation system is basically I'm pumping the tank water to the top and it drips down. So all the plants, all the house plants that's above the water is irrigated with the tank water, which is great because it's a natural filter. So. For example, like I don't even do water change on this guy.
So it's just top off?
Yeah, it's just a auto top off from RO.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So you can see the sensor if you come in, like in the back right here. You see the sensor of the solenoid, that green thing.
Yeah.
So that is a XP Aqua's, what they call like a marriage saver, because it controls the top off level.
Oh.
And then you just top it off. And so basically the maintenance is super easy. You know, I do trimming on the plants every now and then. If I feel like it, I'll gravel
back
like,
a little bit.
Gravel back.
What size is this tank?
That's a 60 gallon.
60 gallon? It looks like it's 6 feet long.
Just shy of 6 feet. 5 feet, actually.
Oh, 5 feet?
5 feet, yeah.
5 feet. Braceless.
Rimless, yep.
And then you have a waterfall over here. What's this fed
made
by?
By Nature Design Studio.
Nature
Design. Shout out to Nature Design Studio. Shameless plug.
But this little waterfall and fog machine, how is this all set up? What is?
Cool, yeah. So basically there's a pump hidden behind, you know, the hardscape. And then the pump sends water into like a little, it's just like a little spillway that I just made it out of like a plastic cup.
I
basically just cut it and then like made a spillway, and then I put the atomizer inside the cup. That's super simple.
And it's filtered by a canister filter.
It's filtered by the Owaza Biomaster Thermal. That's a 650. So that one I really love because you know, I don't have to do the inline heater, and then the maintenance on that is just super easy. I can show you guys later if you want, but yeah, it's super easy.
I'm sure there's maintenance videos out there on those filters, but how did you build this thing in the back? Like everything that's attached to the plants?
Yeah, so the plants are basically, I guess, installed or planted into this backing, which is just a felt. So two layers of felt material that's stapled onto a plastic sheet, PVC sheet.
Mm-hmm.
On the back. So then
you built like almost like a little tank here or something like that.
Yeah, so I built this, basically I cut like a piece of the PVC sheet to on the side so water doesn't, you know, go out of it. But then it's really just a backing, right? And then the backing is secured to the studs in the wall.
Okay.
Yeah, to hold up the weight. And then for example, like the wood right here, you see like the manzanita.
Yeah.
They're basically just secured onto the backing as well.
Nice. And that's felt? That's just like sewing felt of some sort, or what is
that? That's just a polyester felt.
And a couple layers of that?
Two layers, yeah. You just do two layers and then...
And it looks like you like kind of just put the plants in little pockets.
Yeah, basically what you do is like you make a cut of the first layer.
Yeah.
And then you make a pocket and then you staple around the root. And then...
Oh, wow.
Yeah, to make it like a pocket. Yeah.
And how are these plants all watered?
They're watered through the drip system, like you see the irrigation line on top.
Yeah.
So that is supposed to be covered by the felt to, you know, just like for aesthetic reasons,
yeah.
Right? But then I kind of messed up on that one. But then that's just dripping water, you know, down the entire backdrop.
Yeah.
And then, you know, the water's going through the felt. And then the felt, the purpose of the felt is to act as a substrate,
yeah,
right, for the plants for the roots to grow into, and then they keep a level of moisture while maintaining, you know, like really breathable.
And that's on a timer, so a pump in the tank is feeding this?
Yeah, the like there's an irrigation pump right here behind the hardscape, and then that's just timed to water every hour for like 3 minutes, I think, okay. Each time. Yeah.
So that's why you're not doing water changes. Very low stocking, relatively large water volume for as little fish as you have in here.
That's right.
And all of these plants are using up the nutrients within here.
The nitrate's always zero. Like, yeah. Always. Every time I test it, always zero. Doesn't matter how much I feed.
Yeah, just so much plants. That's very naturalistic. Now, these plants down here and the tank itself is lit up by, it looks like there's a hidden light under there.
Yeah, so when I designed this, I basically, you see this log right here in the front coming across. So this was designed with function in mind. Basically, this thing will cover and hide all the lighting for the aquatic section. One thing that I noticed with a lot of the paludarians out there is that they have a great light source for the plants on top, but then that's it. Like the aquatic section is always dim. Or like, you know, very darkly lit. So you can't really see the fish all that well and everything. And then, you know, without so much light, you can't really keep a lot of the aquatic plants on the bottom section. So then I had to devise like some type of thing to house and also hide the lighting for the aquatic section, right? So that's what this is for. And then I have like these little LED like flood lamps.
Oh yeah.
They're like super tiny, right? But then, they're perfect size for, you know, just to strap behind the wood to light the aquatic section.
And you just put it on with like metal twine of some sort?
Yeah, so the plan is to have this log covered by
moss of some
moss,
sort. Yeah, that would be cool.
And then eventually you won't see them anymore.
This is a tank that you like could continuously tinker on and do tiny little improvements, but
oh, yeah.
It would just continuously get better and better at time. Even a pothos. It's the only plant I know on here. And then the top light, mm-hmm. What's that there?
So that's a light from Poland. It's called Skylight.
Okay.
And that's a hyperspot, that's what they call. It's a large hyperspot. This is the light that's, it's just an incredible light.
It's very sexy.
Very sexy, yeah. Like me. And Joey, obviously. Yeah.
I like that it's mirrored.
It is. It's very cool.
When I look up at it, and I'm not being blinded by the light either, it's like it's a really weird experience. I like it a lot.
And the color spectrum, when you see this light, it produces incredible red and blue hues. And then also the cool thing about this, the optic of this light, is that it produces shimmer versus, you know, some of the other LED light on the market, which is like just kind of flat.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is what I love. And it penetrates really deep into the water as well.
It's very cool.
Yeah.
And it's not like, where can we get one of those? Where, like?
Nature Design Studio.
Oh, this is your guys'.
So, no, I'm the distributor for North America.
Nice.
And then,
Could this be used, so obviously this would be on planted tanks.
Yeah, planted tank. I mean, like I've done monster fish tank.
With the same light?
With the same light. It produce like really good results.
I love that it's on the ceiling, like very flush with it.
Right?
It's such a cool experience.
Yeah.
With those, the ceilings here are what, like 10 feet?
This is
not an 8-foot ceiling.
9 foot
ceiling. 9 foot, yeah. Everything, it just seems really big. So it's on a bookshelf, all your books, collection.
And this is actually an IKEA bookshelf.
Yeah, I was going to say, it doesn't look like it's...
So I put these two together, right? So you can bear the weight. Because,
yep.
I mean, like, it's only 60 gallons, so it's not that great. But then... the leveling film foam underneath definitely helps a lot.
Yeah.
But then if you see here, if you zoom in here, there was a leak that happened from, you know, the wall, and then it damaged here, but then I'm gonna fix it somehow. So there's
I didn't even notice it.
Precaution that you need to take around this. And it's really easy if you just seam, like, you know, use silicone to kind of like cover up the seam.
Fill it in, yeah.
Yeah,
you might even just be able to do a wood filler and then sand it down, but in my opinion, you don't really see it. But you should protect it because it is a, of course, press board. But
yeah,
this is not the only tank in this room. This is just a portion of your studio, of course. But you also, this is where you do your work. But then, I think they're going to get a little excited about this because this is a massive empty aquarium. That's one of the coolest shots. I always like to see myself on the other side of an aquarium because it makes me feel like a fish. But
or I can get in it.
What size tank is this?
So this is 450 gallons. It's 8 foot by 3 by 2.5 tall.
Right.
Yeah. Glass and then Euro braced, cross braced on top.
Is that big log I seen on your Instagram story?
By the way, if you're not following Mark on Instagram, I'm going to leave all his links in the description below. Follow him on Instagram. He does have a YouTube channel, and he is about to launch a podcast, which I'm going to be on it in the near future. So I'll leave a link to all his stuff. Go follow him everywhere because he doesn't post the same stuff everywhere like I do. He's always like got something creative on each one. But
Just real quick, sorry, Joey. I am going to freaking go full speed on YouTube because like a lot of these stories you can't really get the full breadth of it on Instagram because it's so short. So I struggle with creating long format contents, but since the King's here and he's taught me a lot of stuff and he encouraged me to be on YouTube, so that's what I'm gonna do. So,
yeah. You're welcome once again, YouTube and everybody on it. I'm trying to get as many awesome aquarists to YouTube, and I've been doing that for a very long time. But I bring up your Instagram because that's where I saw the piece of wood where you dug it out of the side of the highway. Is that what I saw on the way in here? Can we look at that?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay. That's the piece that I saw. I didn't realize it was that big.
Yeah, it's pretty big. Let me stand right next to it.
Yeah.
I'm 5'10", by the way, with shoes, 5'11".
So. with Air Forces. So this is what's going in that big tank in the house. This is incredible. So this is a tree fell over, and then you went and chopped, took a chainsaw to it, and took it home. It's not going to stand like that. So just so everybody knows, this is just standing up. It's going to go flat. Can we pull it out just to see what it looks like? Here, I'll help you.
You're good. Down it goes.
No, we're gently.
Let it slam down, get all that wood or mud off.
Yeah.
Damn!
Yeah, so this is how it's gonna go in the tank. Alright. Yeah. That is cool. Obviously you gotta pressure wash it or clean it up a bit, get all the mud and stuff, but you just drug this home now.
Yep.
What was your plan for it? I know you gotta trim it a bit, but what are you gonna do? How are you gonna get it in the... I don't know how you're gonna get it in the tank, but are you keeping it all or...
So right here, the main portion of the stump, this I'm gonna hollow out, and then the bark section is actually gonna act as a overflow to, not necessarily.
Like you put your filter back here?
Yeah, I'm gonna put the standpipes, like hide the standpipes behind this space. So that this is cool. Gonna be hollowed out. And then it also helps with the buoyancy if I hollow it out.
Oh yeah.
This is what you cut. Yeah,
that's why you were there for hours. I was like, bro, how did this take you hours? No, you cut through 4 feet of wood.
It was so hard. Damn. Especially like around the root area.
Yeah.
Where all these little rocks got embedded into the root.
Yeah.
So what I was doing using the chainsaw, like I saw spark flying, and then basically I ran through three chains.
Hopefully it's worth it. Hopefully it sinks, but I don't know. It is roots tend to be the densest part of a tree. But, what is your overall theme or aesthetic you're going to be going with? Like, what's...
Yeah. So this is going to be a stream tank of let's say Appalachia, so like North American native tank.
Oh, okay.
And then we're gonna have like rainbow shiners and like huge school of them, and then we're gonna have darters and all these native species. It's gonna be awesome.
Such a cool piece of wood, and for free. Well, technically free, but I mean, you had to put in hours upon hours upon hours. If you had to estimate from getting that tank in the house to eventually it being complete, how many hours do you think this is going to take you? Or days, or weeks, or months?
I don't know about hours, but then I want to get fish into the tank by November, early November.
So, this year?
Like in two or 3 weeks' time.
Damn. You got to put this on YouTube, and I'll be honest with you, and you guys will know what I'm talking about. We don't care if it's just little tiny updates, or it's with your phone.
Gotcha.
Just upload the videos.
Okay,
it'll be
cool.
super cool. I think we'd all like it, and to follow along with this build. So again, I'll leave a link to your channel.
So this thing has been sitting on the side of the road for a better part of 2 years, I think. And then I noticed it for like a year ago, more than a year ago. Every time I drive by that spot, I'm like, damn it, I wanted this thing home. I wanted this thing home. So after thought of like just constantly, you know, like thinking about it for over a year, I was like, I'm gonna do it. And then, yeah.
Nice. Well, Mark, this was just a taste of what Mark does. He does this, you know, full time in terms of he installs a tremendous amount of aquariums and aquascapes for customers all over North America. Wait a minute. I was just walking in back into the house and he's got a bit of a storage in his garage for tanks. And I was like, Mark, what is this?
So this is a 200 gallons bowl friend. This is super cool, by the way. It's one of a kind because it's a rimless. Not only is that a huge rimless bowl friend, but the thing is, yeah, the front piece is one piece. See that?
Yeah.
There's no seam. Or, yeah, there's no
seam. There's a seam here.
There's a seam here, but then the front piece is one.
It's glass.
The back piece is one. Yeah.
Nice.
3/4 inch thick, rimless. Also can be ordered on Nature Design Studio.
Perfect. So. And this was, you were mentioning, and here's a stand. This is going to be sexy. You were mentioning this, the tank we just looked at in the house is like almost like a test run to do this. You're going to do it on a massive scale.
Yeah, it's a practice run for, so I sold this project and then the client wants the plan wall. I sold the idea of the plan wall and then I knew that I could do a plan wall. But then the thing is, I've never done it like realistically.
Right.
So then I had to do a practice run to get like all the detail, like, you know, all the, you know, the how-tos and everything, all the details, right?
Yeah.
To get it done correctly. And then that's why I started the Water's Edge. So I can...
Oh, is that what you call that tank in there? The Water's Edge?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And this, the water, I mean, like the plant wall for this one is going to be massive.
Oh, yeah. Because this is what, 8 feet?
This is...
No, seven, six, yeah.
Yeah, 6 feet. But then the thing is...
Looks bigger.
The wall is going to be really tall.
How tall is this tank?
24, I think.
So the stand's probably what, 40 inches?
The stand, yeah.
It's like waist, up to about your waist. And yeah, this is going to, oh, this is going to be a huge project because if that's 28 inches standing up on here, mm-hmm. the whole thing's what, 6 foot?
Yeah.
Likely around that, yeah. And then how tall is the ceiling that it's going in?
Oh, the house, the ceiling of the house is like 12 foot tall.
So, oh, that's going to be incredible.
Yeah, it's an incredible house.
Oh, and this is the matting that you use.
Yeah, that's the one. So I buy them in like big rolls, and then just like make your cutting.
Is it like
polyester?
Kind of looks like carpeting for cars or something. What's its main purpose originally?
I'm not too sure, to be honest. Like some type of insulation, I think.
It's almost like a blanket, like a wool blanket feel. Nice. I gotta do that.
I'll do a tutorial on how to make plan walls.
Yeah.
On my YouTube channel.
Yeah. So, you gotta do all that stuff, man.
I am. Like, there's too many projects, really. So this one, this one is really funny, and I'm super embarrassed to show it because it's a huge mess. But then, obviously, I'm gonna clean this interior area to like make it like nice, right? But then this tank is really funny. So the story of this tank. So this tank, if you look from over here, it's actually quite long. It's 6 feet. So 6 feet by 4 by 2. That's the dimension of this tank.
And it's braceless?
It's braceless.
10 millimeter? Is,
yeah. You notice immediately, but I didn't when I bought the tank from a pet store.
Yeah, that's a reptile tank probably, isn't it?
It was made for puppies.
Yeah. You're not putting water in that. Well, exactly. You can.
So I'm definitely not going to put that much water in this tank. But then after reseal and doing some reinforcements, I'm going to make this one into a big paludarium with reptiles. So I want to do like a friend of mine who goes by Herp Time.
Okay.
He has these incredibly rare and super super illegal to own. They're called Chinese water lizards, I think.
Okay.
Or no, Chinese crocodile lizards.
Ah.
And then, yeah. So just to tell you guys how illegal they are, like you can't even go look for them. Right in the nature, if you go look for them, you get in trouble. They're like on panda level.
Why does he have them?
He got them from like a German breeder that got them like long, long, long time ago. So back then they were okay.
So if you have them and they're captive bred, they're fine.
Right, because he's like kind of grandfather into it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, the first thing I was like, and I seen how long the tank is, And then the first thing I saw was how thin this is. I was like, there's no way.
Right, yeah.
It's a nice tank, but...
So you noticed that right away.
Yeah, it'd be kind of cool to have it lengthwise, front to back coming out, and maybe even a beach type thing. I know you got a different plans, but I've always wanted to do like where the far end of the tank would be kind of like sand building up, and then any type of reptile can kind of crawl into it, but then there's a beach in the front, or water in the front or something like that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it'll be interesting to see what you do. For sure.
Yeah, I'm thinking in my head that I might make it into like a center island, or I'll have it against a wall and then put like a plant wall on the back to, yeah. So, but this one is going to be, you know, some time away.
Yeah. We definitely got some cool projects that are incredibly innovative and interesting, but I'll be honest, this, when I first saw it, and I'm sure a lot of people seen it as well, when you first see that tank that we looked at with the plant wall, you're like, oh, wow, I could never do something like that. But then I started looking at all how you did it, and I was like, I could do that.
Oh, yeah. It's not that hard.
Super cool.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. I got to know, what's going on with this?
So this thing is super cool. I got it off of Craigslist for like $30. And this thing is just, when I saw it, I'm like, that's a perfect, you know, vivarium setup or, you know, whatever. So it's a
obviously this
case.
Isn't going to be on it.
No, this is not going to be on it. But yeah, this is a jewelry display or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And then, so my plan is to basically, obviously, waterproof like the bottom section and then make it into a poison dart frog tank.
That's going to be cool. That. And then you just pull it out to do
to
maintenance.
Yeah, to maintenance.
Damn.
You know, like they should actually start making these.
Yeah, that would actually be kind of cool.
That'd be cool.
All right, I'll leave you alone now.
Yeah.